Now for this video, I have already loaded the bootstrap program into the Mark-8 minicomputer and have loaded in my operating system, which often is called a monitor program. Now this program doesn't do a whole lot. It just allows me to access the Mark-8 through the keyboard of the Teletype rather than from the front panel switches. So what I'm going to do is set it up so you can watch the Teletype, and then I'm going to hit the restart command that will start the program operating. The Teletype is noisy, so you're going to enjoy that in full stereo sound. Okay, I have the camera set up in front of the Teletype, and the first thing we're going to do is turn on the Teletype. Here comes the noise. Next thing we do is throw the computer into the run mode, and then hit the restart instruction. Here goes. Alright, the Mark-8 is ready to go. Now I'm going to ask it what its commands are so we can see what it'll do. Well, as you can see, the Mark-8 monitor that I have running right now doesn't do a whole lot of things, but what it does is very useful for programming and putting things in the Mark-8 and using it. So, let's do a quick demonstration of the dump. Now this lists out whatever is in memory, and we're going to list out the text messages area that I use in the Mark-8 for outputting text messages. I'm not going to do everything, just a short block. There you go. Take a look at the inside of the Teletype. Wasn't that fun? Now for programming, the programming is done in Octal. And I can set the computer to program any location in memory. Tells me what's already there. And then I can insert new information. And I can either do that in Octal, or I can do it in ASCII if I just type an alphanumeric character. The computer knows that it's alphanumeric, and it'll just go ahead and save it. So. Now I want to say 8, but in the computer, it's not going to let me do that. I have to enter in the octal character for 8, which is... There we go. Now we'll escape out of here. Try a dump again. There you go, Mark-8.